Hey, Larry Merchant. How you feeling today? How many rounds did you spar?
Not many.
How many?
Seven.
That's it?
Yeah.
Seven with each one?
No, only seven total.
Seven total?
I got three left for you. What? How are you going to give it a shot?
Hey, why do you love boxing so much?
You know what? It's funny, I hated boxing when I was a kid. I love basketball, but I play college ball.
Where'd you play?
Huh?
Where'd you play?
So it's a small hard-nail college up in Salinas.
What's your name?
I took a hard-nail college.
Okay.
I took out the military. But during the military, I had a smoker. And I got hit the first time, and I was hooked for some reason.
Really?
Yeah.
Basketball came easy to you?
Yeah.
What did you average?
Probably about 16 a game.
That's a lot?
Maybe five
in college? Rounds. That's like on the national level, that's like one of the best in the nation.
And so, in any event, I love this boxing thing. It allows me to push myself and I see. I only get out as much as I put in because I'm out of shape right now.
But you only turned pro, what, 2 years ago?
3 years ago.
3 years. You were 43 years old and you decided, I want to turn pro. Why? Why not just stay amateur?
Because I fought seven fights in amateur.
Uh-huh.
I beat an amateur world. No, actually, I lost. The only person I lost was an amateur world class fighter at the time who kind of went by the wayside because of personal life. And I like it. I still think I got something to offer. I think I have experience. I see a lot of these cruiserweights out there. No ability. No, I'm sorry. All the physical ability in the world. No brain, no smart. And remember this. The composure on the outside of the ring also shows on the inside of the ring.
So
if you act like a fool on the outside, there's no way for you to walk in these ropes and be totally composed.
But why did you hate boxing before?
Because they used to close our basketball gym down when I was a kid and set up the ring for the boxers.
And
back then, Tony Dubs was fighting. I used to see him train at a school called St. Mark's in Cincinnati.
Like Aaron Pryor's from Cincinnati. Adrian Broner from Cincinnati.
Aaron Pryor, too. Adrian Broner, regardless of Pryor's problems, he was never boisterous like this Broner cat. And then now Broner's got to prove and live up to the expectations.
He will. He said,
there's some bad boys in 140 and 147. I think that's why he skipped 140, because...
No, he made history. He became a three-time world champion in three different weight classes.
That means nothing.
That means it means a lot. What do you mean it means nothing? Everybody dreams to be a champion. Don't you want to be a champion?
No, let me tell you the point. I do. That's all I want.
Okay.
But let me tell you why it's migrated from that. Because now Pacquiao, Mayweather, some other names can make a multi-million dollar fight without even being a title fight. So what did I tell you about the belts? Or how the industry looks at the belts? Yeah, I'd love to have a belt.
Who are your favorite fighters right now?
Right now? I like Mayweather's skill. I like Pacquiao's flashiness. No, it's footwork. He's got...
Who? He likes
Kovalov. Oh, we didn't get to the middleweight. I mean, the light heavy. Kovalov is the destroyer. I like him. I like Latif Coyote. Who just moved up.
Have you ever sparred him?
Yeah.
What's that like? Power?
It's like getting hit by a sledgehammer.
He's now a heavyweight.
And he was holding his punches too. He broke my nose, man.
How did he break your
about
nose?
About 3 or 4 weeks ago.
How did he do it?
With right hand.
What? And what happens when you break your nose? You went to the hospital?
Yeah, I swell up and they ain't gonna do nothing for you.
But you look okay now. How did they fix it?
You know what?
They just put it back in place?
My fourth amateur fight I got my nose broke. It's been broke plenty of times. It was no big deal. But he did a good number on it.
Oh my God, man. You're awesome.
I like him as a fighter. All the new Russians that are coming out.
Gennady Golovkin, Yevgeny Gradovich.
Renat Provodnikov. All of them, because of that heart, that will, that determination.
I
really like them.
Mikey Garcia.
Yeah, he's no joke.
Very smart.
He's a solid all-around fighter. Boxer, he can punch. He's a true.
But I saw how guy.
Student of the sport.
But you know what's funny? What you said, like you're a lot of people like you, where they try boxing once and they just get hooked, and you got hooked after like taking a beating. You would think.
Got a headache from this heavyweight.
Yeah.
And I said, and it didn't go away for the day. I said, I'm gonna go back and we're gonna do this again. and that's how I kind of got hooked. I had another headache and another headache.
Why did you wait till you're 43 to turn pro? Why not turn pro at 23?
Married a kid.
This 10 pounds is good.
You know, I fought my amateur last amateur fight, which I think at 26.
And then you took a break for 16 years?
Well, I had a kid, got married. You know, just all got life.
Life.
Yeah. But, you know.
Now you're living a dream.
It's better at 43 than 53.
That's true.
So, if anybody wants to give me a chance, give me a chance. I promise I'm going to come and give a performance.
What weight class do you fight in?
Right now I'm going to be cruiser.
Any cruiserweights you want to call out? Hola, Flavi?
No, I'm not ready for him.
Okay.
That's a guy that'll kill you in a minute if you're not prepared and you're not in shape for him.
He just won a title.
I'm not even at his level yet.
Nah.
I mean, look who he's fighting.
He's a very talented fighter.
But any of these up-and-coming bums that all these promoters try to push through, I'd be more than happy to fight one of them or spar one of them.
Anybody. So there you have it. Who do you give Fighter of the Year 2013 to?
I want to thank Garcia, actually.
Mikey Garcia?
Yeah.
Why?
Because
two titles, two different weight classes, and another win over Juanma, making him do Snow Angels?
That, and it's just that, yes, pretty much he performed. He did. He lived up to expectations this year, and there's some people that counted him out, but you can never count out a solid fighter who is also a puncher.
There you have it right here. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReport.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting.